This video is dedicated to my brothers and sisters, the freelancers. As a freelancer, I have gazillion amount of things I need to do every day. I need to provide service to my customers. I need to work on invoices. I need to work on account receivables. I have marketing, legal, vendors I'm working with, referral fees, and so on, is just overwhelming. So over the years, I found different applications that can help me manage my business easily and automate as much as possible. I'm using Zoho Books for this specific session. If you want more information on how to use it or how to get it with a discount, check the description below. So let's begin. So first of all, in this example, I will show you how I'm getting money from the client in advance using a retainer invoice. The client will pay the retainer invoice and I will provide him services based on the retainer invoice. So that's option number one. Another option is that I'm providing the client value, I'm giving him my hours, and at the end of the week, I will produce an invoice and the client will pay the invoice. Okay, so I will show you those two options. So first of all, let's assume that I have a client. Here I have about three clients and those clients are synced with my Zoho CRM. So everything is being done for me in the backend. But right now, let's assume that this is a standalone and we're getting all those clients. Let's assume that American Comedian is one of my clients and he wants to pay me a retainer invoice. So I will go here to the retainer invoice and I will select him as a client. I will write here, let's say 100 hours and that will be 13,000 bucks. And now he will get the invoice over email and he can pay using Visa or MasterCard. Now, just so you know, Zoho Books can be integrated with Stripe, PayPal, Authorize.net, and a few others. So just know that all those integrations are available. I just sent the invoice to American Comedian and I will record the payment because I just want to show you how it works and it's like he already paid. So now the payment was received. The client will have 13,000 bucks of credit in my account. Now I'm working. I'm going to track time tracking. I'm selecting the project, which is American Comedian is one of my projects. And I'm going to log time. Now, because I need to log time, I will, let's say, do 1 hour and 30 minutes now. And I will write a script for the website. That's the service that I provided him. That will be 130 per hour. I will click save and I will click again and I will create another time log of 1 hour. And that will be a meeting with Bill. So now I have multiple tasks that provided to Bill. Right now I can see all of them, but I want to see only the one that I did not bill yet. And those will be those tasks. Now, if I will go here, I will go to the timesheets, I will select them and I will create on create invoice. I will be able to produce invoice when each one of the line items will include one task. Then my client will get a full, honest, and transparent breakdown of his account. And that's exactly how I want vendors to deal with me. I don't like to get 5,000 bucks invoice. It's not fun. I want to get a detailed invoice to know exactly what was done for me. Now, if you're an honest freelancer, you would probably like this approach. Now, if you are not one and you don't like to give too much details, you can also have the 5,000 bucks invoice instead of a breakdown. And it's you can do it from the invoice settings, just so you know. Now, I produced here the invoice and the invoice total is 715. As you remember, I already collected 13,000. So this invoice, the tax, let me just configure tax for the client. Let's make it HST. And now I will click save and continue. the invoice will be sent. The system is telling me that I have $13,000 worth of credit for the client. I will send the client the invoice for his reference. And I will also click here on apply now to apply the retainer money. Okay, and that will be $807.95. I will apply the entire amount. Okay, so now the credit was applied, the invoice is paid, nothing is due, and the client is fully paid. So that's option number one, how you can build a client. Option number two, I will have in the timesheet, I will go here, I will log a few hours. Let's do it in a different way. And now I will log a weekly log. Okay, the weekly log is a little bit easier to log because I'm just logging everything in one time. So let's say here I did 1 hour, 1 hour a day. Okay. And okay, here I can't do anything because I'm already 24 hours for this day. And the system is telling me that I cannot do more than 24 hours a day. So thank you, Zoho, for helping me here. And I will click save. Now, if I will go back to the timesheets, you can see that I created all those timesheets in the system. I can click here and I can create an invoice. And whenever I will send the invoice to the client will have a way to pay me by clicking on the invoice and pay the invoice. Or I can have an option that the client will store his credit card on file, and whenever I'm producing an invoice, I can click on the button, record payment, and charge the money automatically. When the credit card is being saved on file, just so you know, it's not being saved on your side or Zoho, it's being saved in PayPal or Stripe, so you have zero liability for the credit card, which is extremely, extremely important. I like to show you one more way on how to log time for the client. So that's the feature that I'm using on a daily basis. It's very convenient for me because, as I said before, it's honest and transparent. I will go to the project. I will click on log time. Then I will select the task. Let's assume that I'm working on setup Zoho CRM, the amount per hour, and then I click on start timer. On the bottom, you will see here that the timer is running, as you can see here. And whenever I finish the task, I will click on the stop button and the time entry will be logged automatically for me. At the end of the week, every Sunday, I will go over my timesheets and I will produce the invoice based on the need. Sometimes, let's say that the client is less than 2 hours, so probably I won't produce the invoice yet. I will wait for when the client is accumulating more hours. If it's more than 2 hours, then I will produce it, right? Of course, there are also ways to automate everything and produce the invoice once a week and so on. It's up to you how to manage your business. I prefer to look at my timesheets. Now I want to show you how to produce timesheets using Zoho projects. Zoho Project is a project management system on steroids. The reason that I say on steroids is because you can do everything that a project management system can do, but it can also log time and produce timesheets. So let me show you how it works. I will go to my Zoho one. By the way, all those applications, each one of them is a separate application. It's part of the Zoho one. And the price is $30 per month per user, which means if you're a one-man show, it will cost you $30 per month to manage your entire business using Zoho. So let me find your Zoho projects. That's the one. Okay, I will create a new project. Let's assume that Joe's project is the one. I can have your multiple tasks. Let's say I'm creating here, create a website design. I will assign myself because I'm the only user in the system. I will mark myself that the project starts today and my due date will be next week. The priority will be I, and I will add the task. Now the task is in the system. Whenever I will go to the task, I can click on it. I can provide more information. Let's say there is more description that I need to put in. Let's say that I need to have some comments. Project started and waiting for the client input. I will add the comment and I will change the status waiting for the client, just so I will know. You can upload documents, you can create a forum, you can communicate with your client. Your client can be added to your projects, and you will not need to pay money for him, which means you're paying only for your license. Clients will be free of charge, which I'm adding all my clients to my projects for the sake of transparency. Now, let's go back. When I'm working on a task, I can click here on Start Timer. When I'm clicking on Start Timer, same thing. The timesheet will be collected, and eventually, when I stop and I record the timesheet, here I can see all the timesheets that were collected, and I can produce from all of them an invoice in Zoho Books. As I started the video, I started my career with lots of difficulties to run my business. I wanted to share with you this beautiful application. I'm also a Zoho authorized partner, so this is how I also discovered this beautiful tool. If you will need my help setting up the system, I can give you 1 hour of my time free of charge, as long as you register using my link, which means I will get a kickback from the company, and I can allocate this kickback for you, which means you pay nothing for 1 hour. Anyway, thank you very much for watching this video. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.